Kaishi, it's great that you're here. Yeah, Bill Schwebel, I lead the controls group at Zhang Controls, and I'm looking forward to our discussion.
Yeah, thank you very much, Bill. I am Kaishi Zhang. I lead the product organization for building automation system and the controls here at the Johnson Controls.
Yeah, we're going to have a fantastic discussion about the future of building automation systems.
Absolutely. Speaking of future of building automation, we see a lot of evolving technology. And where do you see the trends and the major customer pain points that you have heard so far?
Well, first off, we have a big technology revolution happening in the building space. So we've been very fortunate because we've seen other industries digitize, and now digitization is coming to commercial buildings. So that gives us opportunity and technology transformation that will help solve a lot of the pain points that we see in customer buildings. One of the biggest issues is we're looking at building owners and they're having a need to upgrade and retrofit their buildings. So they now have some technologies that are very easy to deploy that will help them manage their buildings in a different way into the future. Typically in our industry, we've looked more at the construction event for a building and having systems that were fundamental to operation of the building that would go in on the construction event. Now the technologies are solving a lot of problems around sustainability and energy efficiency. They're solving problems around having healthy, good experience spaces, and then just leveraging the technology to solve a lot of issues we see in the industry around access to good talent, being able to integrate all of the systems across the building to provide that better occupant experience, et cetera. So it's really a good time to be in the building automation space. What do you see as a transformation that's happening with the product portfolios that are addressing some of these problems?
Yeah, absolutely. Johnson Controls, that as you know, we are 140 years young company that has been leading at the forefront of the building automation revolution. You hit the nail on the head. Yes, we are transforming from a siloed approach, focusing on one life cycle stage of the building towards a complete life cycle approach. You talk about during the design, the build, where our control engineers is more concerned about engineering efficiency. How do I get my job done faster? Right? So during this phase, what we are really looking at is how do I enable the zero engineering effort that is really helping reducing the complexity or hiding the complexity from the control engineers, leveraging a lot of tools to be able to streamline the data aggregation. Then during the commissioning phase, similar approach. How do we leverage a lot of digital tools to be able to do remote commissioning and continuous commissioning? And it's all about the data connectivity into the field, into the job site. When you turn from the CapEx towards an OpEx during the operation and the maintenance, how do we address our customers to be able to drive 100% operational efficiency that we call the autonomous operation? In this vision, what we are driving for is really to be able to enable by minimizing the human intervention, by leveraging a lot of tools to be able to drive the preventative maintenance that is able to optimize the building performance, but also minimizing or get rid of the unplanned downtime. Now, it doesn't stop there. Johnson Control, we also look at the building life cycle from a linear life cycle changing towards a circular. When it comes to the upgrade and retrofit, that our system is designed with the future-proof concept that really is the upgrade, be changing a controller or getting a newer version of the software application, it's at our customers' fingertips.
Excellent, excellent. Yeah, that life cycle is critically important, and looking at systems that manage around that life cycle is, you know, one of the new changes that's happening in the future of building automation systems.
So this sounds exciting, Bill. What's your recommendation for our customers? How do they get started on this exciting journey?
Well, the great news is in building automation systems is we're now relying on an open standard, the BACnet standard, which means that all of the equipment interfaces are somewhat standard. And the fact of the matter is that you can put systems on the top of a building, or the top of the building systems, that starts to expose the data of the building. So for an existing building, that's an excellent place to start. Start at the top of the building, put in one of the new connected systems like our Metasys 14 system, and put that into the building and start producing that data. And then you get visibility into the building itself, leverage the tools to see how the building's operating, whether you're running hot and cold sequences at the same time, defective equipment, et cetera. It's a very low cost, almost no cost way to get visibility into your building and get started. In a construction project, look for a system that's integrated. Look for a system that integrates across various domains and various types of systems that pulls that data together and then ensures that life cycle value of the building by having those systems that are integrated. So Kaishi, what excites you most about the future of building automation systems?
Yeah, I mean, here at the Johnson Controls, we see this as more as evolution rather than revolution, because we have been in the last 140 years forefront of bringing innovation and a solution to address customer problems. We were the first one to bring a thermostat in the commercial building, and we are the first one to introduce a modern building automation system. So we have the best people, we have the best products, and our future is really bright.
Yeah, it is amazing. We have that history and that legacy, and the focus on commercial buildings means that we're solving kind of a small subset of the problem. So as an industry, we see a lot of players come in with point solutions. The fact of the matter is that we're seeing this digital technology and we're seeing Johnson Controls approach to it being totally focused on that commercial and industrial building and that problem set. And we're at the beginning of that journey. So today only 5 to 10% of buildings are connected. And within a few years, we'll see a majority of buildings connected, leveraging the technologies that we're working on today to bring into the buildings. And this is going to be an exciting revolution, no different than any of the other analog to digital transformations that have happened in the industry. And having that tool set available to take advantage of that is really exciting.
Absolutely.
Well, good to see you.
Thank you very much.
You bet.